I thought, oh my gosh, he's dying, like literally in front of me.
We saved two people's lives. So if I do nothing else, that was a pretty good win.
Anything he can do to try to make their life a little bit easier for them is what his goal is.
Natural instinct is to run or get away from danger. But something else said, you know, try again.
WXII 12 News presents Salute to Heroes.
Hello, I'm Kenny Beck. The American Red Cross continues to recognize and honor local first responders, our veterans, and Good Samaritans for their selfless acts and contributions to the Triad. This year is the 11th Salute to Heroes Awards, and over the next 30 minutes, you will meet our honorees and hear their extraordinary stories. Our first winner, quite literally, pulled a woman from a burning building in Winston-Salem. Friends call him Superman. He says he was just being neighborly. Here's Roosevelt Hudson. July 5th, 2022, a short time before Clark Avenue in Winston-Salem looked like this, B.J. Harper went to check on her adult daughter, Sonia Smallwood. She has dementia and usually had someone staying with her.
I couldn't get in the back door, and I said, oh, she unlocked the screen door, the storm door, so I came around to the front, and it was locked as well. So I said, Sonia, and I looked in the window, and all I could see was flames on the bed.
That's when she looked next door and found her daughter's longtime neighbor and friend, Roosevelt Hudson, sitting in his truck.
She called, and the first thing she said was dial 911.
While they waited for the fire department to arrive, Roosevelt kicked in the back door and finally got in the house.
I knew the house because I'd been in the house numerous times, and I went from room to room calling for Miss Smallwood, and I didn't get any response.
Then he got to the bedroom.
And as soon as I kicked that door in, heat and smoke just overcame me. So I stepped back into the hallway, and natural instinct is to run or get away from danger. But something else said, you know, try again. I seen a silhouette in the middle of the floor, flames behind it. So I bent over a little bit, went in, grabbed her, pulled her into the hallway, and we fell right here in the hallway.
After that, he dragged her safely outside where her mom and firefighters were waiting.
I just knew everything was gonna be okay. Once he kicked that door in, hey, I was all right.
Definition of
faith, isn't it? That's right.
This video from the Winston-Salem Fire Department shows smoke pouring from the bedroom window of Sonia's room. She spent about 2 months recovering from her injuries and lost everything she owned. But she survived, thanks to her brave and heroic neighbor.
I was being led by a power other than myself. So there was no fear, you know. I mean, I had to be, you know, conscious of what I was doing, which I was.
He is my Superman. I told his wife, I said, I'm sorry. He's my Superman. I'm so grateful that he was there at that time, because if he hadn't been there, I hate to think what would have happened.
I feel honored and happy that, you know, that I was able to be a true neighbor instead of just someone who lives next door.
The Winston-Salem Fire Department ruled the bedroom fire set unintentionally. B.J. Harper says she believes her daughter was burning incense at the time. Sonia was able to move back into her newly built home in late March of this year. Our next honoree is also our youngest. He was just a teenager when he saved a three-month-old baby's life. Peyton's story comes from a family of firefighters, and as luck would have it, his own dad responded to the scene that day too.
From a baby, you could tell he had it in him.
John's story is not at all surprised that his oldest son, Peyton, is now a full-time firefighter, just like he is. Peyton spent a good chunk of his childhood at West Lexington Fire and Rescue.
I would describe it as probably one of the coolest things, getting to come up here and eat supper, just kind of hang around, hang out with the people working. It's a second family, really.
Peyton became a junior firefighter at West Lexington at the age of 13 and a full-fledged state certified firefighter once he turned 18.
As soon as I was able to know what I wanted to do, that's exactly what I wanted to do.
About a year later, at the age of 19, he responded to the call of a lifetime just a few hundred feet from this firehouse.
Structure fire, 69 Echo 9. 5 Estates Drive, number 5 Estates Drive, Cross Street West Center Street Extension, Meadoway. Be advised there is a baby still in the residence. The baby still in the residence is going to be in the bedroom closest to the woods. The baby is in the room closest to the woods.
When you hear that, how does that change your approach?
It changes it a lot. You start running a lot of things through your head, you know, what do I need to do, what's more important, and the best way to go about it, I guess you'd say.
Were you scared? Did you have time to be scared?
I don't think so. It was very fast.
While this was happening, Peyton's father was working at his full-time job at Midway Fire and Rescue, which is more than 12 miles away.
It really, really made me nervous, of course. Listening to everything and not knowing, or knowing that I was not there to help and make sure he was safe, for one. And then once we heard of the infant still inside, it added to the fear, and it just took forever to get here.
While his dad was making his way to the scene, Peyton made his way inside the burning home and found the little baby girl.
She was in a pack and play, so she was really low to the ground. Smoke hadn't banked down that far. It was still very smoky and a toxic environment. She was in almost a car seat, like a cradle. So I was able to pick that up, and she did cry one time whenever I handed her out, so that was kind of a relieving feeling there.
After Peyton passed her out through a broken window, he got out of the burning home safely himself while other firefighters worked to put out the flames. That's about the same time his father arrived.
As soon as we stopped, I was straight off the truck to go find and make sure Peyton was okay. Of course, dead moment kicked in, and I was worried for his safety and make sure he was okay. Then after that, we found out the actual story of what happened, and he was the actual one to make the rescue on it. It really, really made you proud.
Yeah, he's a very big mentor in my life, and I look up to him a lot. So that was pretty cool for him to be there and be with me and talk about it.
It was real emotional. Of course, I didn't let it show at the moment, but deep down, I was happy and relieved.
West Lexington Fire and Rescue Department firefighter Peyton Story. Would you please come up and accept the North Carolina State Firefighters Association?
Peyton has been honored at the local and state level. His boss at the time, former West Lexington Chief Zach Sears, says this new American Red Cross Award is just as well deserved.
I was very excited for him because that's something, I mean, a fireman, that's, they want to make a difference, and that was like life or death. And one of the most serious calls he'll probably ever, he's a hero, yeah.
I'm not a hero. This is a job that you signed up to do, and I was doing my job that morning.
Been on a lot of calls in my years, but never done what he's done. I try to tell everybody to do your best. That morning he done his best.
A few months after the fire, Peyton was able to visit with the family and help deliver donations to them. He said it was a relief to see the little girl doing so much better, and it brought him closure. This next hero has been an emergency responder since last century. She even taught some of her own current supervisors in school. Recently, her job changed dramatically, but also for the better. Here's Laura Smith. Laura Smith has been driving an ambulance around the streets of Forsyth County for more than 25 years, but her career as a paramedic actually started in South Carolina in 1994. She still recalls what one of the speakers said at her graduation ceremony.
He said, EMS can be summed up in just a few words. He said, it's hours of boredom punctuated by moments of sheer terror. And that has held true from that day forward.
She's seen just about every type of emergency, and not that long ago, she also saw her job change. In 2016, she became one of the county's first ever community paramedics.
I would say the biggest part of our job, regardless of what situation we're in, is patient advocacy. So we We speak for the patients when they can't speak for themselves, don't know what to say, don't know what questions to ask, and we help to guide them. We're yet another resource to help guide them through the gaps in the healthcare and behavioral healthcare system.
The idea is to connect people with resources they might not know about and potentially prevent an ambulance ride to the hospital down the road. Part of her responsibilities now involve home visits, particularly with older people.
We love working with the elderly. It's an honor and a privilege. I wish we had more of an Eastern philosophy on taking care of our elderly citizens, because we owe them for taking care of us and even bringing us into existence.
From 2000 to 2008, she taught EMS at Forsyth Tech. Some of her students back then are her supervisors today.
I'm proud of them. Like, they are all excellent students and excellent at this job, and they've stayed with it. They are good leaders, and if they're not, I'm sure to tell them about it, so.
She's calm and compassionate, experienced and giving, and now a hero.
I am honored, but I'm just not about all the hoopla, you know. I'm uncomfortable with the attention. I will say that much. I didn't get in it for the, you know, big, you know, rescue and ooh, superhero and all that kind of stuff. That's not why I got in it. That's not why I stayed in it.
Laura also donates a week of her vacation time every year so she can provide medical coverage for overseas church mission trips. Whenever she retires, she hopes to do even more of that. This next award winner has a passion for helping people and keeping them safe. But if it hadn't been for an accident when he was a teenager, he might have taken an entirely different path. Thankfully for Jeremy Shelton and the community, it all worked out.
Got my life safety educator, level 1, 2, and 3. The first one I received in 2013. I got my level 3 in 2020.
This thick binder is filled with Jeremy Shelton's certifications. And he's not just impressive on paper. He can also pilot a drone and drive a fire truck.
I get to drive home a truck every day that's got lights and sirens on it that I can turn on and turn the woo-woos on. You know, everybody loves the woo-woos. Little kids love the woo-woos.
However, the story of how Rockingham County's assistant fire marshal got into public safety is a little odd. It started when he was burning trash as a teenager, which is now against the law.
My granddaddy's grapevine was on fire. The trash had blew up and set the grapevine on fire. So first thing I thought of was run up to the back of my granddad's house and grabbed his garden hose and run back down there and put the grapevine out. I said, well, that was really cool. I think I'll be a fireman.
A few years later, he started as a volunteer with the Wentworth Fire Department, where he's now a captain and training officer. But in his job with the county, his main focus is on fire prevention, education, and investigation. He teaches children the basics, even dressing up as Sparky the fire dog from time to time. He makes sure that businesses have their fire alarms and extinguishers where they're supposed to be, and he's a staunch advocate for the elderly, helping to secure funding for these deaf and hard of hearing alarms.
It has a strobe light on top, as well as it has a bed shaker that goes in between the mattress and the box springs, and it works with any fire alarm that was manufactured after 1996. You think about most elderly people, they're on a fixed income, correct? That one fire alarm is $250. That's one of those things that if I can come out and put it in for free, they don't have to worry about it. It's not a choice they have to make.
His boss, Rockingham County Fire Marshal Melissa Joyce, is also the person who nominated him for this award.
Jeremy is just a helper of all people. Anything he can do to try to make their life a little bit easier for them is what his goal is.
It's about helping your community. That so often gets lost.
And as for winning this honor?
I've always tried to be a humble person. I just always tried to do what I felt was right.
I'm truly excited for him that he's finally going to be seen for the person that he is.
I'm one of those guys, if you call me up, Jeremy, I'm in a bind, the water's busted, I need some help. Hold up, I'll be over there in a little bit. We get up and you put your clothes on, you go help them out. I mean, that's what it's about.
Jeremy recently put together a local honor guard group for emergency responders in the county who have passed away. This next hero calls himself a man of action. He served our country during Vietnam and he continues to serve people in the triad when they are having their worst day. Meet Henry Harper of Winston-Salem.
This is Satcher Page. Say hello to Kenny Satcher.
Hi, Kenny.
Henry L. Harper is a huge baseball fan and had hopes of playing in the pros himself after graduating from Carver High School in 1969.
Man, that's when I found out reality. There are better players around these United States than what Henry Harper was. So after dropping out of college, I decided to go in the Air Force. I had no clue to what the Air Force could offer me at the time. It was getting away from home, getting away from Mr. and Mrs. Harper, and being a man.
He served from 1971 to 1975 as a member of the security police. While he was stationed in Thailand, his base was hit by enemy fire.
Scary. A John Wayne movie. You could see the traces from the bullets in the air.
He credits his faith with getting him through the toughest of times, including a less than warm welcome home from Vietnam. Harper spent more than 30 years as a laborer and driver for R.J. Reynolds, then ran a bail bond company before he started the next chapter of his life as a member of the disaster action team with the American Red Cross.
My personality fits the responder that the community need in terms of being compassionate, sympathetic, and understanding people in a time of need. You know, just the other night, I went on a fire call. Lady lost a dog. Family was burned out at 3 o'clock in the morning.
That's tough, isn't it?
Very, very tough.
Another middle of the night call he took centers around this service dog, Duty. He belongs to Howard Little, who is autistic, also a Red Cross volunteer, and the man who nominated him for this award.
He came over here at 3 in the morning, got me so that I could be at the airport at 4 so that I could go to California to help out with the sheltering there. True greatness comes in service, and that's what Henry does all the time. He goes out in the middle of the night all the time.
Henry has received a Certificate of Achievement from the Governor and a Lifetime Achievement Award from the President for his volunteerism. Now the American Red Cross says Henry L. Harper is a hero.
It's incredible. I think it's great that Henry did that.
The heroes that I see are the single mothers and fathers who are raising kids. Those are the heroes. The school teacher who take a salary and buy extra materials for kids. I'm not a hero. I'm just Henry Harper, somebody who's trying to make a difference in the community.
Henry's granddaughter, Alicia Washington, became the first black valedictorian in 100 years at R.J. Reynolds High School back in June. And Henry's daughter is also the woman that fellow Salute to Heroes Award winner Roosevelt Hudson saved from her burning home earlier in this broadcast in July of 2022. Next, they usually send first responders to emergencies outside of their building, but when the emergency was inside of it, they ended up saving a coworker's life.